Good morning, students. Myself, Dr. Balasubramanian, working as assistant professor in the Department of Zoology, Government First Grade College and PG Center, Chintamani. So today, we are going to discuss about the respiration in the case of arthropoda. Now, respiration in the case of arthropoda is convoluted divided into two topics. One, we saw last class, that is the gills, and other is the book gills. So gills in the case of the crustacea, particularly prawn, and book gills in the case of the limulus or king crab. So that also is the another example. Now in this class, we see about the trachea and lungs, book lungs. So here we discuss about the respiratory system. Now arthropods constitute 3/4 of the animal kingdom and inhabit in the various of habitats. So as you know, these arthropods are the first invertebrates to be successfully adapted to the aerial mode of life. So till then, annelida we had in the water. Now these arthropods, they are first invertebrates to be evolved successfully on the land. And these arthropods, out of them, they constitute about 70% of the total invertebrates. And out of them, so there is a class insecta. So again, it is again a most predominant and dominant class among the phylum arthropoda. Now, this class insecta, we have this breathing in the air, that is the, in the terrestrial environment. Now, respiration in the case of the cockroach. So, in the case of the insects, see, there is a class insecta in the phylum arthropoda. Now, in the class insecta, we have the majority group of animals, which includes the cockroaches, the termites, the honeybees, and the lot of pests, which the agricultural crops, which they damage the crops. So these pests, whether it's a butterfly or so many insects are there. So this class insecta is a major class in the phylum arthropoda. Now great majority of insects breathe in the air by means of elaborate and most efficient gas exchange system made up of branching elastic air tubes or trachea. So this called the tracheal system. In majority of insects, tracheal system serves for the transport of oxygen and carbon dioxide. So here you should understand. So these insects breathe air by an elaborate and most efficient gas exchange system made up of branching elastic air tubes or trachea. Now what are trachea? Trachea are the branching elastic air tubes called the tracheal system. So what is tracheal system? The tracheal system is made up of branching elastic air tubes are found in the class insecta. So that is the respiration by means of trachea. So in all the members which respire through the trachea, so there is a branching elastic air tubes. That air tubes are called trachea. Now in this tracheal system serves as a transport of exchange of gases. So these particularly animals require oxygen, and these tissues release the carbon dioxide as one of the byproduct. Now in each trachea is a air tube lined with the epithelial cells and spiral ridges called tinea. Each trachea is an air tube lined with the epithelial cells and spiral ridges called tinea. Now, what is a trachea? So, trachea is an air tube lined with epithelial cells and spiral ridges called tinea. Now, the trachea open externally by small openings called spiracles. Trachea open externally by small openings called spiracles, through which the air enters the system, through which the air enters the organism. The trachea are branched into finer branches called tracheoles, which are air capillaries in the inner tinidial ridges. So the difference here between the trachea and tracheoles is that the trachea has the spiral ridges called tinidae, whereas these tracheoles, they don't have the tinidial ridges. So that's the difference between the trachea and tracheoles. So these trachea and tracheoles are two important respiratory structures as far as the respiration in the case of the arthropoda is concerned, particularly the class insecta. So we will find a lot of the members of the insecta particularly the honeybees, the house flies, the termites, the butterflies, the silk insects, silk moths, etc. So many things, so many insects which are the pests for the agricultural crops. So they also belongs to the class insect. The breathing is affected by the paired pterygosternal muscles, which connects the dorsal side of the body with the ventral side, and hence the contraction compresses the abdominal cavity, forcing air to move outside. So, the breathing is affected by the paired pterygosternal muscles, which connects the dorsal side of the body with the ventral side, and hence their contraction compresses the abdominal cavity, forcing the air to move. The relaxation of these muscles brings the abdominal cavity into the original shape, sucking the air into tracheal tubes. So, in many aquatic insects, such as the mayfly and dragonfly, the tracheal gills are so there for respiration in the water. So, there is another adaptation. So, aquatic insects, larvae, particularly the larvae, the adults respire by trachea, but the larvae respire by tracheal gills. So therefore, we told this some in arthropods, they live both in land and water. So they both live land and water. That means the examples are the mayfly and dragonfly, the classical examples. So they lead the amphibious life. So the larval stages live in the water, whereas the adults they are living in the terrestrial environments. So the relaxation and the contraction of these muscles help to air to enter and air to exit outside. Now, the respiration of the cockroach is a network of trachea known as tracheal system. They respire through the small openings called spiracles. So here, there are spiracles. You can observe the spiracles. These openings are regulated by muscular sphincters. These openings of the spiracles are regulated by the muscular sphincters. They breathe in oxygen, rich air through spiracles, which open to the tracheal tubes. So here the spiracles are there and the tracheal tubes inside. These are tracheal tubes, there is an exchange of gases. So trachea open to the tracheoles. Now here, clearly diagrammatic representation of the diagram, the tracheal tubes are the network of air tubes meant for smooth exchange of gases. They are found in insects. The tracheal tubes are the network of air tubes meant for smooth exchange of gases. So here, the air getting inside the body of cockroach, the spiracles. So here the spiracles are there, the surface of the body of the organisms. So here the air enters and this is called the trachea. The air then rushes to the tracheal tubes and then diffuses into the different body tissues and cells. So there is exchange of gases directly between the body tissues and the cells, and there is exchange of gases. The trachea is then divided into thinner tubes called tracheoles. The tracheoles contain network of fluids which flow throughout the body of insects. So this is a very important character, where the trachea is subdivided into thinner tubes called tracheoles. The tracheoles contain network of fluids which flows throughout the body of the insects. The air-rich carbon dioxide rushes towards the tracheal tubes and finally exhaled out to the spiracles. So that's what. So here, what you understand here, the trachea are there and the trachea lead the tracheoles, and the tracheoles are surrounded by the fluids, and these fluids contain the the carbon dioxide rich material, and these tracheoles has the oxygen, and this diffusion of gases taking place between the tracheoles and the fluids. So here this oxygen enters the tissues, and this carbon dioxide from the tissues come to the tracheoles, and from the tracheoles now it passes to the tracheal tubes and finally exhaled out to the spiracles. So this is about the respiratory system in the case of the cockroach. Finally, the fourth type of respiratory system is the book lungs. So book lungs is a respiratory organ. It is found in certain air-breathing arachnid arthropods such as scorpions and spiders. So scorpions and spiders has the book lungs. So this cross-section of book lungs, so here this is the animal, the spider, where you can observe the book lungs. So these are the lamellae of the lung, and this is the atrium or the spaces and blood between the lamellae, and this air flowing in through the respiratory openings. So this is how this air is entering from the outside, and this lamellae of the lungs, actually the bucles. So what happens is carry the tissues with the carbon dioxide, and here this oxygen is there. Now carbon dioxide come outside here, and this oxygen now enters into the tissues. The series of thin plates is present in each book lungs. So thin plates are arranged in relation to each other like the pages of the book. So thin plates are richly supplied with the blood. So this is a very important feature. A series of thin plates is present in each book lungs. Thin plates are arranged in relation to each other like the pages of book. So therefore it is called book gills. So book lungs. So just like the pages of the book, so these pages are called the lamellae, and just like the pages of the book, these thin plates are arranged in the thin series like thing, and is a book lungs. Here the hemolymph is filled with the unfolded pages or plates of the book. The folds maximize the extensive surface for the exchange of oxygen and carbon dioxide with the surrounding air. So this thing is there. Now this lamellae is richly supplied with the hemolymph, and this these plates they have a large area for exposure to the atmospheric air, and this atmospheric air is rich in oxygen, and the tissues as rich in carbon dioxide. So actually this is actually diffusion taking place from the region of higher concentration, region of lower concentration. Now this oxygen from the outside now enter into the tissues, and in the tissues we find the carbon dioxide, and this carbon dioxide easily diffuses out to the outside. That is the exchange of gases, that is by means of diffusion. So there are four pairs of book lungs in the case of scorpions, and two in the spiders. So no motion of plates is needed to facilitate this kind of respiration in most species. So the plates are fixed, and these plates they carry the hemolymph, and they have the tissues with rich of carbon dioxide. Hemolymph has a carbon dioxide and is exposed to the oxygen, and this is the exchange of gases. Okay, finally summary of this respiratory system. The tracheal tubes are the network of air tubes meant for smooth exchange of gases. They are found only in insects. The air then rushes through the tracheal tubes and then diffuses out the different body tissues and cells. So this is a type of respiratory system in the case of the cockroach, the honeybees, the termites, and the butterflies, and the silk moths, and so many other types of insects, particularly the pests of the agricultural crops. There are the four blades of scorpions up in the two in the spiders. No motion of the blades is needed to facilitate this kind of respiration in most of the species. So this is the summary of the respiratory system, particularly with reference to trachea and book. Now finally the references, we saw the Godpal textbook and Godpal and Jordan Verma and Ekabana Thayer and Dame and Dame and Simplesa. So before closing the topic, so you should know that respiration is a biological oxidation of food molecules so as to release the useful energy from ATP. So this oxygen is required for the breakdown of the for the burning of the fuels for the oxidation of food molecules so as to release the useful energy from ATP. So therefore the animals have the aerobic respiration. Further, so for any respiration to occur, for any respiration process, physiological process, respiration process to occur, so there are three main criteria. So these three main criteria should understand what are the three main criteria to facilitate the respiration. So first of all, that the way the respiration takes place, so that place should be highly vascularized. That place should be highly vascularized, and there should be rich supply of blood. Any place, so that they should be supplied the blood. One. Second thing, that place should be moist. The area where the respiration occurs, that should be moist. So it should richly supplied with the moisture, or richly supplied with the some sort of air content, or the moisture content in that place. So then the third one, that the brain should be highly thin. So this respiration will occur where the places are very thin. So particularly in higher animals, human beings, we have alveoli. So alveoli are very thin and they highly vascularized, and highly moisture. So there should be moisture. There should be moisture content in the respiratory places. They should be highly vascularized, and that places should be very thin, extremely thin. So these three criteria are very important for the respiration to occur in any organism. So you should understand that where are the respiration, illele respiration agate, alli the three criteria should be met. What are the three criteria for the respiration to meet? And they should be, that place should be highly vascularized, that place should be highly thin, and third one, it should be highly moisturized. So these three criteria are meant for respiration. So thank you for listening. Thank you.